This is our new chapter, graph incompatibility and stock sign relationship. So the first, what is meant by graph incompatibility? That means the inability of two different plants grafted or budded together to produce a successful union. And to develop into a composite plant is termed as graft incompatibility. Graft failure can be caused by anatomical mismatching, poor craftsmanship and adverse environmental condition. This is an graft incompatibility. The major causes of graft incompatibility is adverse physiological response between the grafting pattern, virus and phytoplasma transmission, anatomical abnormalities of vascular tissue in the callus bridge. Okay, so for the graft, for the new successful of new plant, both graft sign and rootstock, both are compatible with each other. Okay, so if inability of two different plants grafted or budded together to produce a successful plant, it is called as graft incompatibility. Two plants are failure to develop a new plant. Okay, this is called as graft incompatibility. There are different causes of graft incompatibility. So the first external symptoms of graft incompatibility. Symptoms of graft incompatibility: failure to form a successful graft or bud union in a high percentage of cases. At the time of incompatibility, yellowing of foliage in the later part of the growing season, followed by the early defoliation, decline in a vegetative growth, and appearance of shoot dieback and general ill health of the tree. Okay, if the graft incompatibility may be occur on that plant, so the plant shows the yellowing of foliage, then defoliation, then decline the vegetative growth, and shows the appearance of shoot dieback. Then premature death of the tree, which may live for only year or 2 years in the nursery. Then mark difference in the growth rate of the scion and rootstock. Some difference may be occur in growth of rootstock and scion. Overgrowth at above or below graft union. Suckering of rootstock. Sometimes only rootstock can produce a sucker, but the scion cannot be produce new growth or new vegetative growth. Then breakdown of graft union cleanly. There are different types of graft incompatibility. First one is the localized, that is non-translocated graft incompatibility. And the second one is the translocated graft incompatibility. First, localized or non-translocated. Graft combination in which mutual compatible interest of overcome in ability in incompatibility of the scion and rootstock. The rootstock rootstock prevents physical contact of the rootstock, and interstock prevents the physical contact of the rootstock and scion, and affects the physiology of normal incompatible scion and rootstock. Interstock, that means the portion of union of rootstock and scion. That portion, it is called as interstock. Okay. So the interstock prevents physical contact between the rootstock and scion, and that affects the physiology of normally incompatible scion and rootstock. Then some examples of localized incompatibility is Bartlett pear on twins rootstock, when mutually compatible old home or Bury Hardy is used as an interstock, the three graft combination is completely compatible and satisfactory tree growth take place. Okay. Sometimes, for example, bartlet pear, and on the rootstock is quince rootstock. On the quince, bartlet pear is grafted. Then the they are mutually compatible. Old home or this Buri Hardy is used as an interstock, and three graft combination is completely compatible and satisfactory tea growth takes place. Next one is the translocated incompatibility. It includes certain graft rootstock combination in which insertion of mutually compatible interstock does not overcome incompatibility. Okay, so this is translocated. Sometimes combination in which insertion of mutually compatible interstock does not overcome incompatibility. This can be recognized by the development of brown line or necrotic area in the bark at the rootstock interface. So how to judge translocated graft incompatibility? This is the brown line or necrotic area in the bark of the rootstock interface. Then consequently, carbohydrate movement from the spine to the rootstock is restricted at the graft union. Carbohydrate movement from the spine to the rootstock is restricted. Hale early peach grafted onto Myrobalan B plum rootstock is an example of translocated incompatibility. This is the example of peach, early peach. Hale early peach is grafted on Myrobalan B plum rootstock. This is the Myrobalan B is the rootstock of plum, and Hale early is the sign of peach. Okay. So the grafting can show the translocated incompatibility. The tissue are dissolved and weak uniform form. Abnormal quantities of starch accumulate at the base of the peach sign if the mutual compatible Brompton plum is used as interstock between the Hale early peach and Myrobalan P plum rootstock. The incompatibility system persists and accumulation of starch in the Brompton interstock. This is the example of translocated incompatibility. Next one is the non-Pirelli almond on the Marianne 26-24 plum rootstock shows the complete phloem breakdown through the xylem tissue connection are quite satisfactory. In contrast, Texas almond on Mariana 26-24 plum rootstock produce a compatible combination. Insertion of 15 cm piece of the Texas almond as the interstock between the non-Pirelli almond and incompatibility between the two components. So this is one of the example non-Pirelli almond grafted on the Mariana 26-24 plum rootstock. This is this shows the complete phloem breakdown or xylem tissue connection. Okay, then next one is the delayed incompatibility. Some apricot cultivars grafted onto the Myrobalan plum rootstock will not break the grafting union until the trees are full grown and bearing crop. Delayed incompatibility, that means the Myrobalan plum rootstock will not break the graft union until the trees are fully grown and bearing. Graft incompatibility can be take place along as a 20 years to occur. Okay, so this type of incompatibility cannot be occur after the grafting. that can be take place after 20 years of grafting. Okay. Other examples, conifers, oaks, and the checks on Padha, Prunus, Cerasoid, rootstock. Okay. Then next one is the pathogen-induced incompatibility. This sometimes some pathogens are also responsible for the incompatibility. The graft union failure arisen incompatibility symptoms, but due to the pathogens like virus or phytoplasma. Tristeza is an important example of virus induced incompatibility in a citrus. Okay, so the in a citrus, the Tristeza, this is very very harmful disease to citrus crop. Failure of sweet orange, citrus sinensis, budded onto a sour orange, citrus aurantium. Rootstock is due to the toxic substances from the sweet orange, but lethal to the sour orange rootstock. Okay, sometimes sweet orange is budded onto the sour orange. Okay, in citrus, the toxic substances can be produced from the sweet orange, and that substances can be lethal to the sour orange. Okay, so that's why sometimes the graft incompatibility may be occur. Other examples are black lying in an English walnut, Juglans regia, which infects susceptible walnut rootstock, apple union necrosis and decline on the brown line of prune, which is caused by tomato mosaic virus that is transmitted by soil-borne nematodes to the rootstock and then to the graft union. Sometimes soil-borne diseases are also responsible for the graft incompatibility. The nematodes are transmitted into the from the soil to the rootstock and then transmitted to the graft union portion. Then PR decline is due to the phytoplasma rather than the virus. In pathogen, some nematodes, some viruses, some phytoplasma, and some fungal disease can be produce the incompatibility. Then causes and mechanism of incompatibility. The large number of different genotypes that can be combined by grafting produce a wide range of different physiological, biochemical, anatomical interactions in grafted. Several hypotheses have been advanced in attempt to explain incompatibility. First one is the physiological and biochemical mechanism. In case of incompatibility, combination of certain clear cultivars on a clean rootstock, the incompatibility caused by cyanogenic leucocyte. Then Prunus normally found in a clean but not in a clear tissue. Okay, some glycoids are also present in clean but not present in a clear tissue. Okay. So that is why incompatibility may be occur in the combination of queens and pears. Then prunacin is translocated from the queens into the phloem to the pear. The pear tissue break down the prunacin in the region of the graft union, which hydrocyanic acid is as one of the decomposition products. So the prunacin is translocated in the queen. This is the queen is the rootstock, and prunacin is the compound present in the.
Ma'am, आवाज नहीं येते तुमचा.
Prunacin is the compound present in the queen rootstock, and this compound is translocated into the phloem to the pear. And the pear tissue break down the prunacin in the region of graft union, The hydrocyanic acid is one of the decomposition. The hydrocyanic acid is the decomposition of one of the decomposition products. Okay, the presence of hydrocyanic acid leads to the lack of cambial activity of the grafting union, which produces anatomical disturbance in the phloem and xylem at the resulting union. The phloem tissue are gradually destroyed at and above the graft union. So the grafting success of grafting, first one, the cambium tissue is very important. The attachment done of cambium tissue for the successful of grafting. So the hydrocyanic acid can interfere the disturbance in the xylem and phloem tissue or in the cambium tissue. So that's why the grafting compatibility may be occur. Then conduction of water and material is seriously reduced in the both xylem and phloem. The presence of cyanogenic glucosides in a woody plant is restricted to a relative few genera. Hence, the relation cannot be considered as a universal cause of graft incompatibility. Sometimes the water and material are also seriously reduces the xylem and phloem. And the presence of cyanogenic glucoids can restrict the relatively few genera. Okay, so this relation cannot be considered as a universal cause of graft union. Then modification of cell and tissue. The lignification process.
Hello. The lignification process is process of cell in a wall is important. Graft adjoining cell walls in the graft union is of an incompatible combination contains no lignin and rare interlock only by cellulose fibers with incompatible apricot, plum or graft. Some callus differentiation into the cambium and vascular tissue does occur. However, the large portion of the callus never differentiate or the union that occurs in mechanically weak. Sometimes the lignification process of cell wall of a cell in a wall is important for the formation of strong union in Pierre Quin's graft. But the adjoining cell wall हेलो सेल्युलर सेल्युलर रिकॉग्निशन सेल्युलर रिकॉग्निशन इज डिफाइंड एज द यूनियन ऑफ स्पेसिफिक सेल्युलर ग्रुप्स ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ इंटरैक्टिंग सेल दैट रिजल्ट्स इन अ स्पेसिफिक डिफाइंड रिस्पॉन्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल पोलिन स्टिंग्मा कंपेटिबिलिटी रिकॉग्निशन रिस्पॉन्स विथ ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन सर्फेस रिसेप्टर इन अ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट cellular recognition that means the union of specific cellular groups on the surface of interacting cell and that is the result in specific defined response pollen stigma compatibility recognition response with the glycoprotein surface receptor in flowering plants it is has been postulated that the critical event deciding compatible and incompatible graft may occur that the callus cell first touch. There may be cellular recognition that must occur in a successful graft formation. This is the main reason of mechanism of graft incompatibility. Then predicting incompatibility combination. Sometimes to able to predict in advance of grafting where whether or not the components of proposed cyan and stock relation combination are compatible will be tremendous value. There is different methods of incompatibility. How to test the graft incompatibility? First, electrophoresis test. This is the electrophoresis test. The test is being used for testing the cambial peroxide's binding pattern of the cyan and rootstock of chestnut, oak, and maple. This is the peroxide. This is the cambium binding pattern. Cambial binding peroxide binding pattern of cyan and rootstock. Peroxide mediate the lignin production, increase the peroxide's activity occurs in a incompatible graft as compared to the compatible autograft, and adjacent rootstock and cyan cells must produce a similar lignin and have identical peroxide enzymes patterns to ensure the development of functional vascular system across the graft union with electrophoresis if the peroxide band match the combination may be compatible if they do not match is incompatible may be predicted okay so the both rootstock and cyan rootstock and cyan binding pattern if the both rootstock and cyan binding pattern can be matched together that means the that are compatible with each other if they do not match that means it is incompatible okay then magnetic resonance imaging it is can be used to detect the vascular discontinuity in the bud union of apple okay for the grafting or budding all factors like cambium tissue vascular and phloem tissue are matched together if the discontinuity may be occur on that budding or grafting that may show the incompatibility then high magnetic resonance imaging signal intensity is associated with bound water in live tissue and establishment of vascular continuity between the rootstock and cyan magnetic resonance imaging may be useful to detecting the graft incompatibility caused by poor vascular connection okay then correcting incompatible combination this is not a practical cost effective way to correct large scale planting of incompatible grafting partners plant would normally be rough and discarded with the perhaps some isolated specimen trees of value if the compatibility is discovered before the tree die or break off the union. A bridge graft could be done with the mutually compatible rootstock. Another costly alternative is to inlays of compatible rootstock. The March seedlings would be eventful become main root system. So this is the in this type of correcting incompatible combination. That means in for the correcting of incompatibility, we can use inarch grafting or a bridge grafting. Okay. Then rootstock and sign relationship. A grafted or budded plant can produce unusual growth patterns, which may be different from what would have occurred if each component part of the graftage, with example, rootstock and scion was grown separately on when it is grafted or budded in other types of rootstock. Some of these have a major horticultural value. The varying aspects of rootstock will influence the performance of scion cultivar, or vice versa, is known as rootstock and scion relationship. Okay, so first, scion and rootstock and scion relationship. That means the effect of rootstock. What is the effect of rootstock on scion, and scion effect on rootstock? Okay, influence of or the performance of scion cultivar on the rootstock and rootstock cultivar on the scion. Effect of rootstock on scion cultivar. Okay, so the size and growth habit, effect of rootstock on scion cultivar. In apple, rootstock can be classified dwarf, semi-dwarf, vigorous, very vigorous rootstock based on their effect on the scion cultivar. Okay, so the size, in that case, size and growth, the rootstock, if the rootstock, if you use the rootstock, dwarfing rootstock, the plants may be, the new plant can be dwarf plant. That means the effect of rootstock on scion plant. If the scion is grafted on dwarf rootstock, that is M9, this is apple rootstock, the scion grows less vigorously and remains dwarf only. On the other hand, if the same scion is grafted on very vigorous rootstock, example M2, the scion grows very vigorously. Okay, if you graft the plants on dwarf rootstock, that means the scion grows less vigorously and remain dwarf. Okay, and on other hand, if you graft the scion on very vigorous rootstock, the scion grows very vigorously. Okay, so in a citrus, trifoliate orange is considered to be a most dwarfing rootstock for the grape and sweet orange. On the other hand, in mango, all plants of a given variety are known to have the same characteristics, canopy, shape of variety, despite of rootstock being of seedling origin. Some dwarfing rootstock of mango, like Kalapadi, Olar, have been found to impart the dwarfness in the scion cultivar. In guava, grafted on Psidium pumilum are found to be dwarf in suture. Then Pusa Srijan, guava rootstock also imparts the dwarfness in Allahabad Sapeda, a commercial cultivar of guava. Some examples of mango, then guava. Okay, the dwarf rootstock can produce a dwarfing effect on scion part. Okay, then next one, the precocity in a flowering and fruiting. Effect of rootstock on scion. The time taken from the planting to fruiting, that is precocity, is influenced by rootstock. Generally, fruit precocity is associated with dwarfing rootstock, and slowness of fruiting with vigorous rootstock. Fruit precocity is associated with dwarfing rootstock and slowness of fruiting with vigorous rootstock. If the if the plant is in a dwarf, then plant can produce as early flowering and fruiting as compared to the tall plant. Mandarin, when the grafted on jamberi rootstock, is a precocious than those grafted on sweet orange or acid lime rootstock. This is the jamberi rootstock that can be used for sweet orange and acid lime, okay, and orange, then fruit set and yield. The rootstock directly influence on the production of flower and fruit setting fruits in Oriental persimmon diaspora khaki when it is grafted on diasporous lotus. It produces more flower but only a few mature into fruits. However, when the diasporous khaki is used as a rootstock, the fruit set is very high. This is one of the example of a persimmon. The rootstock directly influence on the production of flower and fruit setting. Okay, if when the grafted on diasporous lotus, this is one of the rootstock. It produces more flowers. Okay, persimmon diasporous khaki grafted on the diasporous lotus, it produces more flowers, but only few flowers into few flowers. Fruits are mature into the fruits. But the diasporous khaki is used as a rootstock. The fruit set is very high. The influence of rootstock on the yield performance of cultivar has been well documented in the many fruit crops like acid lime budded on the rough lemon register nearly 70% increase the yield than the budded on Prior Citrange, a Rang Pru Lime, or the its own rootstock. Then sweet orange variety Sadgudi, budded on the Kichli rootstock, gave the higher yield than the Jamberi or its own seedlings. So the fruit set, the rootstock is also affects on the fruit set and yield. If the rootstock produces the lower fruit sets, that means the cyan is also produced lower fruit set. Then fruit size and quality. Sadgudi sweet orange grafted on Gajanima rootstock produce a large but poor quality fruits, while its own root, they produce fruit with high juice content and quality. Okay. If you use a rootstock like Gajanima for the Sadgudi orange, they produce a poor quality fruits. And then if the Sadgudi orange are grafted on its own plant, own roots, that can produce a high juice content and high quality fruits. The physiological disorder granulation in a sweet orange is very low if on the Cleopatra mandarin seedling. On the other hand, rough lemon seedling stocks induce maximum granulation. The physiological disorder black ant in the Bartlett pear did not appear if the Pyrus communis was used as the rootstock. When Pyrus pyrifolia was used as a rootstock, disorder appeared affecting the fruit quality. The nutrient status of cyan. Rootstock do not influence the nutrient status of the cyan also. Sadgudi orange tree have a better nutrient status of all nutrient in the leaves when budded on the citrus Volcarimania rootstock than its own rootstock or a Cleopatra mandarin rootstock. This is the nutrient status of cyan. Rootstock do not influence the nutrient status of cyan. Okay. Winter hardiness, young grapefruit tree on Rangpur line withstand winter injury better than on the rough lemon or on the sour orange, sweet orange, mandarin and trifoliate stocks were more cold hardy. Grapefruit, if the grapefruit are grafted on the Rangpur line, that can be withstand in a winter injury than the rough lemon on rough lemon or sour orange. Then disease resistance. In a citrus, considerable variability exists among the rootstock in their response to disease and nematodes. For instance, a rough lemon rootstock is tolerant to tristeza or xyloporosis and exocortis, but it is susceptible to gumosis and nematode. On other hand, the triad citrine is tolerant to gumosis but susceptible to exocortis virus. Similarly, guava variety grafted on Chinese guava, Psidium, Phrygisthylium, resistant to wilt disease and nematode. Some of the disease resistant rootstock can be used for the grafting or the budding that can produce the plant, new plant produce a resistant plant for that specific disease or specific viruses. Ability to resist a soil adverse condition. Among the citrus rootstock, foliage orange exhibits a poor ability, while sweet orange, sour orange, Rangpur lime rootstock exhibit a moderate ability to resist excess of salt in the soil. Some rootstock are the salt resistant rootstock. For example, foliage orange exhibit the poor ability as compared to the sweet orange, sour orange, Rangpur lime, etc. Similarly, a palm fruits variation exists among rootstock to resist excess soil moisture or excess boron in the soil. Then Marabolan plum rootstock generally tolerate excess boron moisture than the Marabolan plum root and other rootstock like peas, apricot and almond. This is the effect of rootstock on cyan. Next one is the effect of cyan on rootstock. Vigor of the rootstock. In apple, it has been found that the apple seedlings were budded with a red expression apple. The rootstock produced a very fibrous root system with a few tap roots. On other hand, if the cyan golden bark was budded on the root seedlings, they produced two or three branch deep root without fiber root system. In a citrus, cyan cultivar is less vigorous than the rootstock. The rate of growth and the ultimate size of the tree is more determined by the cyan rather than the rootstock. Okay, so vigor on the rootstock. This is the effect of cyan on rootstock. If you use the vigorous rootstock, vigorous cyan, apple seedlings were budded with the red astrachan apple. The rootstock produced a very fibrous root system with a few tap roots. Okay, if you use the vigor rootstock. On the other hand, if the cyan golden bark was budded on the seedlings, they produced two or three prolonged deep roots without fibrous root system. Then cold hardiness of rootstock. Cold hardiness of citrus root is affected by the cyan cultivar. Sour orange seedlings budded to the Eureka suffered much more from winter injury than the unbudded seedlings. The budded seedlings can be suffer more than the unbudded seedling with the inter injury than the unbudded seedlings. Precocity of flowering. Young mango rootstock seedlings 6 month or two to 1 month old were found to put forth inflorescence when the branches from old trees are enlarged, which can be attributed to influence of cyan on the rootstock. The young rootstock young mango rootstock seedlings 6 to 1 year old were found to put forth inflorescence when the branches from the old trees and enlarged, which can attribute the influence of cyan on the rootstock. This is the enlarged grafting. Only 6 to 1 month old rootstock can be enlarged with the cyan plant that can produce a precoce, that can put forth the inflorescence. Okay, as compared to the unbudded or the ungrafted plants, if the enlarging is done in the old trees, the flowering can be occur as early than the ungrafted or budded plant. Factor influencing the healing of graft union. Incompatibility. Certain rootstock and cyan are incompatible. Therefore, the graft union between the two will not normally take place. This is the graft incompatibility. The two rootstock and cyan cannot be grow normally. Kind of the plant, some species like oaks are difficult to graft, but the apple and pear are very easy to producing a successful graft union. Then environmental factors during flowering grafting. There are certain environmental requirements which must be met a foliar for callus tissue to develop and heal the graft union. Some environmental factors are also responsible for the graft union, like temperature has a pronounced effect on the production of the callus tissue, and optimum temperature is essential for the production of callus. In most of the temperate fruit crops, callus production is retarded after 42.5 degrees Celsius. That means the high temperature can affect the graft union. Then relative humidity must be high, is maintaining a film of water against the callusing surface is essential to prevent this delicate thin wall parenchyma cells from drying. So the relative humidity, high relative humidity is also affects on the grafting process. Then presence of high oxygen content near the surface is essential. Then growth activity of the stock plants. Some propagation methods such as T-budding, that is sealed budding, bark grafting depends upon the bark slipping, which means the cambial cells are actively dividing and producing young thin wall cells on the sides of the cambium. These newly formed cells separate readily from one another and the bark is slips. Okay. So some propagation method is also affects on the graft union. Then propagation technique. Sometimes the techniques used in the grafting are so poor that only a small portion of the cambium regions of the stalk and scion are brought together. This may result in the failure of the graft union. Okay, some grafting techniques are very poor, and that means the only small portion of the cambium regions of the stalk and scion are brought together. For the successful grafting, the stalk and scion cambium tissue are brought are attached together or joined together, so that can produce a new plant or a successful grafting. Okay, so this is all about rootstock and scion relationship and graft incompatibility.